Hello, 8th standard students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine. Now, we will start to solve exercise 5.1. We already have started to study our 5th topic, that is data handling, and now we will solve exercise 5.1. Question number 1. For which of these would you use a histogram to show the data? You know very well what is histogram. When we have to hide some data, or when data is not there for some time or for some situation, that time we are hiding that data by using the jagged line. So which graph is used jagged line? That graph is known as histogram. My first question is, the number of letters for different areas in postman's bag. And the solution is, the number of areas cannot be represented in class intervals. So we cannot use the histogram to show the data. Okay, the question is the number of letters of different areas in postman's bags. Okay, we have to find out the number of areas. Okay, but the number is area may be different, so it will be difficult to represent in the class intervals. So if we cannot find out the class intervals, that means we cannot use the histogram to show the data. Second, the height of the competitors in an athletics meet. And the height of competitors can be divided into intervals. So we can use histogram here. Okay, now you will take the examples. There are five competitors in an athletics meet. Okay, and their height is, suppose, 168 centimeter, or 166 centimeter, 171 centimeter, 174 centimeter. So these numbers you can be divided into intervals. You can make a groups which having width their width 5, 10, as like that. So with using different numbers of widths of the groups, you can divide this number into the intervals, into the class groups. So height of the competitors can be divided into intervals, so we can use histogram here. For example, take height in centimeter and number of competitor. This is the another examples that in the first column you can see this. Here we can make a groups. Okay, so this is 150 to 160, 160 to 170, 170 to 180, 180 to 190. So their width is 10. How I can find out the width? So 160 minus 150. Okay, so I get here answer 10. So the width or the size of this class group is 10. So as like that, we can divide them into the intervals, and we can also find out the numbers of competitors by using telemarks. So the answer of this question is, height of competitors can be divided into intervals, so we can use histogram here. The numbers of cassettes produced by companies. Companies cannot be divided into intervals, so we cannot use histogram here. Now you can see the numbers of cassettes produced by 5 companies. Okay, we know that there are the 5 companies. Okay, and these numbers, these companies cannot be divided into class groups. Okay, so we have, if we draw the bar graph with the help of this given information, we can use a one bar for one company. second bar for second company, third bar for third company. So it is not necessary to show the intervals, or by it is not necessary to find out the class groups, okay, because we know that there are the five companies and easily we can show the five companies data on the graph. So it is not necessary to divide them into class groups. So companies cannot be divided into intervals, so we cannot use histogram here. The numbers of passengers boarding trains from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. at a station. Okay, time for boarding train can be divided into intervals. Okay, from so we can use histogram here. Look at here for one more example. The time in hours and times of passengers. So 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. is there. 10 a.m. is 1 p.m. 1 p.m. to 4 p.m., 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Now you can see this 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. So if I want to find out the size of this class group, I have to do here subtraction. So 10 minus 7 is equal to 3. So size of the class group is, or width of the class is 3. So as like that, 10 to 1. So how you will find out? It is a timing. And when we are drawing a clock, you can see that their numbers are up till 12. So 11, 12 and 1, again 3. So the size of the class group is 3. So with the help of this class grouping, we can find out the numbers of passengers by using the telemarks. So time for boarding the train can be divided into intervals, which intervals are the same. So we can use histogram here. Question number 2. The shoppers who come to the a departmental store are marked as man for M and woman as W, boy as capital B and or girl as capital G. The following list gives the shoppers who came during the first hour in the morning. Okay, you can read that the list which gives the shopper to come during the first hour in the morning. I will wait for the some time, start to read that list. Now with the help of this list, you have to make a frequency distribution table using telemarks and draw a bar graph to illustrate it. Now look at here the solution. We have to make a three columns which shows shoppers, telemarks and frequency. Okay, now we are going to find out the telemarks for M. Now look at here carefully. Okay, now M, how many times M are coming here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So how many times M is coming here for? 15. Now look at here 15. Okay, 15 frequency is 15. Now I have to find out the W, that means list of women, numbers of women. Look at here carefully. Okay. Now I'm going to change my pen, number, color of pen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27 and 28. So how many W's are there? 28. Look at here, W, 28. Now we have to find out the B, number of boys. 1, 2, 3, 4, and here 5. So how many boys are there? 5. Look at here. B, 5. Now we have to find out the numbers of G, that means number of girls. Again, I will change the color of my pen. Okay, I will use your highlighter to show that, so you easily you can recognize. So 1, 2, 3, here 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So how many girls are there? 12. So as like that, we can find out the frequency of the man, women's, boys and girls. So we get here frequency, total frequency is 60. Okay. Now with the help of this table, now we have to draw the bar graph. Now look at here. So one by one we will draw here a bar graph. Okay. Now if you have any graph book, you can take it to draw this bar graph, or if you not have the, at this time, then you can use your notebook also. What is the first step? First step is that you have to draw this horizontal line and this vertical line which are joined to each other. Okay. Then on this is x-axis, this horizontal line is x-axis, and this is you have to write y-axis. So on the x-axis you have to give the numbers or main data of the given information, that is M, W, B and G. So four main datas are there. So we have to draw here four bars. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have to write here these names M, W. But when you are taking the correct measurement, this interval should be same. Okay. Already we have explained into the introduction of this topic. So now how many frequencies are there? 4, as 15 28 5 and 12. So we will take here intervals as 10 20 30 40 50 and 60. Already you know that how to take measurements on graph. Between 1 centimeter there are the 10 short lines. With the help of these 10 short lines, small lines, you have to count the numbers. Okay, so as like that you have to draw a small point or line on the 15, 28, 5 and 12, and you can draw this bar. Dear students, while solving the bar graph, if you have any doubt, you can ask me anytime. But you already have studied in this last year, and now you have to draw it bar graph in a systematic way. So try to draw this bar graph and check it yourself with this video. But when you finish drawing of your bar graph, you have to write the scale on y-axis. Why we have to write the scale only on y-axis? Because x-axis shows the fixed data, but on the y numbers it varies as per their numbers of data. So you have to write that scale on the y-axis. Now look at here, this is the first 1 centimeter, and on 1 centimeter we wrote here 10. After 1 centimeter we wrote here 10, 20. So the width is 10, because 20 minus 10 is equal to 10. So 1 centimeter is equal to 10 units. It carries half marks while we are checking the papers. So it is necessary to write the scale while drawing the bar graph. Now the next question is, the weekly wages of 30 workers in a factory are, okay, and these are the weekly wages. And using telemarks, make a frequency table with intervals as 800 to 810, 810 to 820, and so on. Now you can see this. Here are occurs two times. So if 110 is came while marking the telemarks, where you will take, you have to choose that you have to take higher class intervals or lower class intervals. Okay, now look at here how you can draw the table. As like this, you have to make three columns: class intervals, telemarks, and frequency. Now we are taking 800 to 810, 810 to 820, 820 to 830, 830 to 840, 840 to 850. So as like this, we have to count the intervals. Okay, why we are choosing only this much? You can see this. The smallest number is 804 and the biggest number is 890. So we want one more class intervals. So we will for like this up till 890 to 900. Okay. Now we are using telemarks and we have to find out the frequency. Okay. Now look at here. 830, where it will come? 830 to 830, which you will use as a higher class mark or is a lower class mark, that you have to find out yourself. So we will use here higher class mark or lower class mark. So one by one, by doing telemarks, you can form this table. So 830 will be chosen as a higher class mark. Okay. So 835 will come between 830 to 840. 890 will come between, already 890 it occurs two times, but we already have decided to choose 890 as higher class mark. So we will draw here 1. 810. Again, we already have choose that higher class mark, so we have to put that 810 in this group. So as like this, one by one, you can find out the telemarks and frequency. Just do yourself and find and check it yourself with this video that you have formed the correct answer or not. And if you have any confusion or any doubt, you can ask me anytime. Question number 4, draw a histogram for the frequency table made for the data in question 3 and answer the following questions. Okay, this is our data that we have already find out with the help of question number 3. And as like this, with the help of this, we have drawn here histogram. You can see this class intervals we have shown on the x-axis. Look at here, 800 to 810, 800 to 820, 820 to 830, 830 to 840, 840 to 850, 850 to 860, 860 to 870, 870 to 880, 880 to 890, 890 to 900. And you can see this, all these bars are joined to each other. And the frequency shows 3, 2, 1, 9, 5, 1, 3, 1, 1, 4. So directly we are taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up till 10. So 1 centimeter is for 1 unit. So what we have to write here, scale? Scale on y-axis, that 1 centimeter is 1 unit. Now by using this frequency, we will mark these lines on 3, 2, 1, 9, as like these others and we will draw a bar. Okay, now you can see this, the class interval is directly from that 800. What about to 0 to 800? So about 0 to 800 we don't have any data. So we have to hide that place. So to hide that place on the graph, we will use here that jag line. Okay, what is this jag line? And if you are using this jag line, that means it is a histogram. So what will be the first question? Which group has the maximum numbers of worker? Okay, now from this bar graph easily you can see that the highest number is 9 and and its class interval is 830 to 840. So my answer is group 830 to 840 has the maximum numbers of workers, that is 9. How many workers earn 850 and more? So we 850 and more, so we have to use we have to count from 850 and so on. So what is from 850? 1 3 1 1 4. So what is the total? 1 and 3 4, 4 and 1 5, 5 and 1 6, 6 and 4 10. So what will be the answer? 10 workers earn equal and more than 850. Okay, so dear student, as like that you have to solve the question number 3 by using the frequency table made for the data in question number 3. By using the pausing key, or you can stop this video and you can solve these examples yourself. So how many workers earn less than the 850? Okay, now look at here, we have to find out the less than 50. So we have to count here before the 850. So what will come here? 5, 9, 1, 2, 3. So addition of these numbers, we will get here the answer that 20 workers earn less than 850 refers to the frequency table of question number 3. Dear students, already we know that, you can see this in question number 3. It gives the frequency, total frequency is 30. Okay, we know that from the numbers of workers are 850 and more than are 10. So how many workers are earn less than 850? So 30 minus 10, 20. So with the help of this oral calculation, I can see that my answer is correct. So the question number 5. The number of hours for which students of a particular class watched television during holidays is shown through the given graph, and answer the following question. And the graph is this. X axis shows hours of TV watched per day and Y axis shows number of students. So my first question is, for how many hours did the maximum numbers of students watch? Okay, how many maximum numbers of students which are watching? That is 32. And for how many hours? 4 to 5 hours. So my answer will be 32 is the maximum numbers of students who watch TV for 4 to 5 hours. My second question, how many students watch TV for less than 4 hours? 4 hours. So we have to find out the less than 4 hours. So we have to count from 4 to my left hand side. That means for 22 plus 8 plus 4. So my answer is 34 students watch TV for less than 4 hours. My third question, how many students spends more than 5 hours watching TV? More than 5, that means we have to add the numbers of students which shows the graph after 4 to 5. So my answer is 8 plus 6, that is 14 students watch TV for more than 5 hours. So as like that, you have to solve this exercise 5.1 yourself. So dear student, don't waste your time. Try to solve this exercise 5.1, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me anytime. Till then, have a good day.